1999 to 2000, all the computers were going to stop working because they wouldn't read the year as 2000, but as 1900. So the computer would track it as 1998 was 98, 1999 was just written as 99. People were saying banks weren't going to work anymore. They look at your deposits and what you had in the year 1900 instead of 2000. Thought that the computer grids for utilities weren't going to work, that there wasn't going to be any electricity, there might not be any heat. And so people had to prepare for that. Or not. I guess you could have looked at it two ways. One, you could have just buried your head in the sand and just thought everything will be fine, or you could have, if it was your job at work, to make sure the computers right software was patched in and everything would be okay. Then you had to prepare in that time leading up to New Year's Eve. I had a friend who told me a story that he had headed back home, back to Michigan for that New Year's Eve. His family was having a big party on New Year's Eve. His sisters were there, everyone was there, cousins, nephews, nieces. And he was going to play a trick. As it was getting close to midnight and as the ball was dropping in Times Square, he went downstairs where the breaker was. His sister had bought into this hook, line, and sinker and thought that everything was going to shut down, and so he thought he'd have a little fun with it. He sat down there in the basement by the breaker. It was about 5 minutes too, and he said, he started playing through his mind everything that could have happened once he pulled the breaker. His sister was going to go hysterical. She'd bump into her dad, and he'd bump into the china cabinet, and the china cabinet would fall on cousin Tyler. And it wouldn't be when Y2K came, but when John was irresponsible and killed Tyler. So he said, nah, I'm not going to do that. So he went upstairs and didn't tell anybody about what he had thought to do. As Y2K was approaching, people needed to get ready for it. We get some money out just in case. I think maybe that was the start of doomsday preppers. Could have happened to be ready. But there's a greater event than Y2K to get ready for. Jesus gives us words to live by. As we prepare not for 2000 when the calendar clicks over, but for when the end of time clicks over. When he comes again in judgment. How are we going to do that? What does Advent mean for you?
Now, you may know Advent is that word from the Latin language that means coming. And it reminds us that, yes, just as Jesus came at Christmas, he's coming again.
What does Advent mean? I'm not looking for a definition.
What does this time between Thanksgiving and Christmas mean? How is it going to affect you?
Jesus gives us words to live by. He says, be on guard. Be alert. You do not know when that time will come.
He wanted to prepare his disciples. He wanted to get them ready for something when he would no longer be with them physically. They had some questions about what that meant, and so Jesus told them this story. He said, it's like a man going away. Jesus going away. He leaves his house and puts his servants in charge. Us. With each assigned to his task.
unlike Y2K, and unlike Christmas, we don't know when this day comes.
Back in 1999, you could look at the calendar and know how much time you had to get ready. Today, you can look at the calendar and know how much time you got ready to get ready for Christmas, but this day, this event, the most important event to be ready for, we don't know when it's coming, so Jesus says, watch. Don't be that door person found sleeping, whose job it was to watch and make sure and get ready and see when the owners come and let everybody know. It's not just a matter of getting distracted. When I get distracted, I sin. And I recognize that deep inside of me, there's the same problem that happened with those people back in Noah's day. You, I, them. we focus in on who it is, the one that's coming, that changes our attitude. It's not an attitude of doom and gloom, but one of rejoicing, because he says, I'm coming. You're Jesus. Yeah, I told you to be watchful.
Says to you, dear distracted Christian, I had you in my sights when I came. I came in a manger, it was because of you. Focused on you. When I lived a life that was perfect, it was because I was thinking of you. When I hung on the cross, I had you on my mind. When I rose from the grave, it was you. Thank you.